Zafarnai depicts many ideas about his opinion on poetry in this poetry, as well as his personal experience with it. One of the main ideas that he conveys is the freedom of expression and that it is intended for everyone. This poem's first stanza consists of 15 lines that define what the poem means to the author. Line 1 mentions that this poem is like a rhythm, which is significant because it tells the reader that there is soul, passion, and movement in this poem and that they should be prepared to experience it. The next line expresses the message's intensity, as Zafana mentions that the tongue fires a rhythm like gunshots, loud, impactful, and powerful. Further, he explains that this poem was designed to express his rage musically. The fifth line is significant because Zafana expresses that he does not write to shape the opinions of his readers or for his poetry to put people to sleep. Poetry need not have any sort of structure or seriousness that way. Then he expands on this claim by stating that he does not expect people to follow him like blind sheep, because his message is about empowering people to live their lives by being alert and mindful of their words and actions. Furthermore, he makes it clear that he is not asking people to be critical of political or personal views. Rather, it is a poem about accepting oneself. Lines 10 to 13 describe this poem as a part of the author's identity. This is extremely relevant because Zephaniah is a poet, so words, rhythms, and verses are constantly on his mind. Line 13 emphasizes that no matter where he goes in life, his identity will always be a part of him, as it demonstrates his desire to encourage individuals, including himself, to embrace their rhythm. He mentions having tried Shakespeare and respects him for his work. However, he prefers his own writing because it has no boundaries and allows him to be himself openly. These concluding lines go to show that poets should not be forced to respect or follow poetry from history. Rather, they should be allowed to construct whatever form of this art that pleases them. Just as an individual's identity is unrestricted, so should poetry be. The final stanza of the poem has 37 lines. Lines 16 to 19 express Zephaniah's beliefs that no matter how the poem is written, it should be printed, especially if it is written to be more powerful as a spoken word. This poem does not have long words or proper structure, but that doesn't mean it isn't powerful or doesn't have a strong message. Poetry is more about meaning and the verbal rhythm than how it is presented or structured. Line 20 continues to explain why. He believes that attempting to be something he is not as a poet, like a romantic, will only ruin his work because it will not be authentic, nor will it provide him with any form of freedom. Line 21 communicates to the reader that Zafarnai took something with which he felt he could easily identify with, reggae rhythm that is, and created a poem that would allow the reader to experience a small chunk of his existence as a poet and a person in general. The next two lines explain to the reader why he chose to display this specific aspect of his identity. He felt that writing a more emotional piece would not stand out to his audience, and he wanted to present something new. Lines 24 and 25 deliver the idea that Zephaniah did not find the concept of writing a very personal poem appealing, because he believes it would be lost in a sea of words and poems that came before him. Line 26 compares his poem to dub ranting, a type of oral presentation of poetic works, telling the reader that there is more to this poem than the way it has been written, and that much more could be experienced if it was also heard the way Zafarnai intended. Lines 28 and 29 convey that this poem should be experienced with your entire body as you become engrossed in its rhythm. In the next five lines, Zafarnai also mentions that you don't have to be wise or foolish, old or young, to enjoy this poem. Rather, it is accessible for everyone. Lines 33 and 34 caution the reader or listener to take the poetry just as it is, instead of scrutinizing it, because Zafarnai made it for enjoyment. The last few lines depict Zafarnai's powerful energy as he depicts himself chanting day and night through every circumstance that life throws his way, because that is how he celebrates himself and his identity. It is revealed that he has become most educated about himself, which is something that everyone should know more than anything else. Finally, the poem concludes with Zephaniah proclaiming that this poem is such a big part of him and that he is putting it out in the world with nothing but love. Thank you.